These could be my butterfly wings. What do you think? Hi Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer, here to empower you to arrange and play Celtic music. Today we're going to talk about something exciting. I think it's exciting. I think of it as the magic chord, from which a bunch of other chord patterns spring. You probably have seen me play it a million times and have seen it in my arrangements, but we're going to go through it really slowly and go through several variations on this pattern. But before we get started, I would like to invite you all to join my new Facebook group, Mastering the Celtic Harp. There's a link below where you can join. This group is all about collecting and sharing resources, especially for learning Celtic music. And not just harpers are invited, other instrumentalists are welcome as well. So I'm hoping to foster some good discussions about session playing, about learning the harp, learning how to play Celtic music, and getting better at it and mastering our instruments. So I hope you will join me there. A word of caution before you attempt this magic chord. This is not something I would teach to beginners. You want to make sure that you have good control over your fourth finger. You're used to using all four fingers. So if you just started playing, I would suggest bookmarking this video and saving it for later. I will have a handout of this magic chord and its variations in my description that you can download, so make sure you check there, and let's get started. Alright, I have a new perspective today, so you can see my left hand a little more clearly. I'm going to start us off in the key of C to demonstrate this. And what I mean by the magic chord, what I think of as the magic chord that I default to and make variations on, is just the good old 1-5-8. Right? C, G, C. And if you get used to making this your default shape that you go to, I think your arrangements are just gonna sound so much more grown up automatically without even trying. The reason they're called 1-5-8s is because of the scale degree numbers. So if you number your scale, let's be in C for now, we're going to play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1 is always going to be your home chord. If you're in C, 1 is always C. Count up from 5 from there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's your G. So your G chord is your 5 chord. It's also the 5th scale degree. Count up 4 more. So from 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 is your octave. So that's what we mean by 1, 5, 8. The first scale degree, the 5th, and the 8th. So let's first explore how to properly play this 1-5-8, and then we're going to talk about several different variations on it. So of course we're going to use fingers 4, 2, and 1. We're going to tuck 3 down. We're not going to close 3. That's going to make your hand tense, right? You're not going to touch your palm with number 3. You're just going to have it hang loosely so it's out of the way of the other fingers, but not so close that it makes your hand tight and have to work to close it. So just hanging out of the way. You want to, of course, keep your pinky with number 4. Use some tape if they're not behaving themselves. So generally, in general, keep it there as long as your pinky is relaxed, right? If you do tend to stick it out, it can make your hand more tense. So just make sure you keep your pinky relaxed. That's going to be on C. Second finger on G. Again, 3 is just bent out of the way. And then 1 on the top C, the middle C. Practice rolling it. And I would practice this, if you're not used to it, going through different chord progressions. Pick some of your songs or your lead sheets, and then practice going from that chord to that chord to that chord in the same exact shape. You can also play, practice it just, not even playing the chord, just placing it, giving a little squeeze. Then let's place it on an F, for example, F, C, F, give a little squeeze. Place it on a G, G, D, G, give a little squeeze. Just practice going back and forth from different chords. It's a bit like playing guitar, right? If you've ever played guitar, you want to practice going from one chord shape to the next chord shape smoothly without pausing. It's the same idea here. Practice rolling them, playing them as a block. I'm going to go in the key of G for now and show you an example of just throwing in 1/5/8 into an arrangement. Just using plain 1/5/8 chords. So let's talk about how we'd want to spice that up too. I don't think it sounds bad, but to create some variations, let's talk about different patterns we could do that are all sort of based on this idea of 1/5/8. I'm going to go back in C here for these other patterns, and the first one I'm going to show you is a 1/5/8/7. We're going to play the first degree, fifth, eighth, and before you play eighth, just bring your second finger one string below and play the seventh of the scale, and that sounds like this. Gives it that nice kind of a seventh chord feel. The next one I want to show you is the 1/5/8/9. I use this one in my pattern sheet for the Skyboat song. I'll link that in the cards. And that's this one. So you play your 1/5/8, cross your second finger under your thumb before you play your thumb, and play the string right above your thumb. Similar to that is a 1/5/9. So just a 1 and a 5, G and a C and a G, if we're doing it in C. And then just bypass that octave and go one higher. Gives it that nice, pretty sus 2 feel. That's where you take out the third of a chord and replace it with number 2. So 1/5/9. Next one I'm going to show you is the 1/5/8/9/10. I'm sure you've seen this before. A lot of this in Starlight, the one we learned last month. I'll also put that in the description. So we're going to play 1/5/8, and before you play the thumb, just cross the second finger under to the D in this case, and then before you play the second finger, your thumb's just going to go one higher to the 10th degree. Next one I'm going to show you is the 1/5/10. Love this one. We're really just playing the same notes of a triad, C, E, G, but we're flipping it around, playing the C and the G and then the E on top. It's a very wide triad. You can think of it as a wide triad. And that just sounds very different than... By the way, if your hands are a bit small to reach 1/5/10, don't worry about placing them all right away. Place 4 and 2, keep 3 tucked, and then before you play 2, just get your 1 up to that 10. So you can roll up to it. Not a big deal. The next one I want to show you is the 1/5/10/9/8. So I also do this in the Skyboat song video. Play 1 and 5, 10, and then just put your 2 and 3 right underneath it. I'm going to play a few tunes for you now that use these patterns, and I'm going to be in G, and I'd like you to see if you can recognize the ones we've been talking about. First one is number 58. I'll put that in the cards for you if you want to learn it. Notice about 58. We started with 1/5/8/9/10, 15876. Just slow that last one down a little. A similar one here. I did that similar to 1 5 8 9 10 in G, but I started on an E chord. So it's technically an E, a 1 5 10 11 12. You could think of it that way. And then a 1 5 9. So that we have those two clashy notes. And that was C, G, D. So let's talk about Alden River now. This is also in G. So there's a great tutorial of this by Rachel Hare. I'll link that as well. This is a very pretty tune by a guitarist from the Isle of Man named Paul Kringle. Just an example, I started with a lot of 1 5 10s. This is just the way I play it. 1 5 10 in a G, right? So G, D, B. Another 1 5 10, C, G, E. I might do like a 1 5 10 and then another 12 on top of that, or 1 5 8 9 10. And here I like to do that 1 5 8 7 and just kind of leave it hanging for the next chord. It might be 1 5 8 or 1 5 8 9 10 here. To go back to that middle note from your 1 5 10. Right? So I'm just gonna play one more. I'll play Fanny Power really quick, the Carillon tune, and you kind of just see that my default is that shape, that 1 5 8 shape, and you just kind of get used to doing the other variations around it. To improvise if you get used to that shape and some of its variations. And just see how it makes your arrangement sound. Thanks for coming along. Let me know what you thought about this chord and its variations. Are there any more variations that you use all the time? Go ahead and put those in the comments. We want to hear them. If you want to see more videos on arranging ideas like this, you can click this playlist right here. It's all about arranging. If you want to click my face up there, you can subscribe so you don't miss next week's video. And if you want to check out my Patreon page, I have all sorts of extra harp goodies to aid you in mastering your instrument. I'll see you next week. Bye!